psychological hazard is any hazard that affects the mental well-being or mental health of the worker by overwhelming individual coping mechanisms and impacting the worker's ability to work in a healthy and safe manner.
There are two types of the psychological hazard, work-related violence and work-related stress. For work-related violence, such as bully, is usually involved act of verbal comment that could mentally hurt a person at the workplace. Next is customer aggression, unacceptable behavior by current or former customer that can lead to fight or offensive situation. For work-related stress, for example, fatigue is ongoing state of tiredness due to the irregular working schedule. Other than that, work-related mental stress is when job demand or responsibility is greater than what a person can comfortably manage.
Next are the effect and illness caused by the psychological hazard. The first example of hazard is bullying in workplace. Bullying in workplace can cause psychological risks to workers who experience such behavior. The constant stress from this hazard may lead to deterioration of the worker's mental health. Furthermore, it may lead to sleep disorder like insomnia and sleep apnea. Next are the effects from customer aggression. The worker will start to be hesitant in making choices or taking decisions. Besides, their communication skills will start to deteriorate because they are scared to talk to people. When the condition becomes severe, it may lead to generalized anxiety disorder. Symptoms of GAD are constant anxiety, fatigue, muscle pain, and difficulty to stay focused.
The third effect due to psychological hazard is the consumption of alcohol. Alcohol consumption leads to serious adverse physical and mental health effects such as liver cancer, heart failure, depression and violence, to name a few. And if this negative behavior is conducted in the premise of workplace, strict actions will be taken, such as monetary penalty and also dismissal from work altogether for breaking the code of ethics in the workplace. The last effect is difficulty to attend emergencies. When someone is having depression or anxiety, the person will avoid large group of people and wants to be alone. Unfortunately, if incident happens to the person, there is no one to take immediate actions.
Bullying at workplace can be mitigated by promoting a positive workplace culture and treating each other with respect. Workplace policy which forbids bullying should be developed. Help desk and hotline numbers to report bullying can be set up too. Extending flexible working options reduces workplace stress. Comprehensive wellness programs such as mental health programs are beneficial. Regular communication and counseling by qualified experts reduce stress among employees. Making changes to workplace environment to improve lighting, ventilation, and reduce noise mitigates workplace fatigue. Bathroom breaks and pantry enable tired employees to refresh themselves. Work rescheduling could be done by limiting night shift work. Fatigue risk management system also controls workplace fatigue.